You know, living for God is not a restriction. I know there's this internal fight or internal argument that you and I go through sometimes. Why can't I do this? Why can't I go here? Why can't I be with this person? Why can't I? And you know what? That is the same argument that the enemy of our souls brought to the first human beings, Adam and Eve. God had created such a paradise for Adam and Eve to enjoy the fruits of his creation, to enjoy. They had everything that they could ever want and need. They were in the presence of God. I mean, they were set up for life. And here comes the enemy. And of course, like a good enemy, instead of showing them everything that God had for them, he pointed out the one thing that God said was off limits. One tree amongst who knows how many trees, but one tree. And he said, you know what? Basically what he was saying, what kind of God is this? Who will restrict you from eating this? Doesn't he know that you want this? Doesn't he know that you need this? I mean, if you do this, you can be like him. And that's what the enemy is doing all day long. What kind of God is this? I mean, doesn't he see that this makes you feel good, that this gives you excitement, brings you so much fun? But what the enemy doesn't let us in on is the reason why God says this certain thing is off limits. See, anything that God tells us to do or don't do is for our own good. It is to benefit our own lives. Benefit to promote the well-being of your life, your entire life. And guess what? God knows past, present, future. We don't. God knows what's ahead of us. We don't. So if God is saying, you know, don't do this, don't go here, don't speak to this person, don't engage with this person, no, you can't be in a relationship with this person, you gotta know that there's a reason why he said off limits. The reason that God puts restrictions and boundaries on us now is so that we can enjoy a boundless, restriction-free life later. So he's really not restricting us. He's not saying, no, you can't, you can't, you can't. But what he really is saying, no, not yet. Or no, I have something better. The reason why God is telling his believers, his children, no, or telling me, no, this kind of sex, this sex outside of my creation of commitment is off limits. No, this kind of sex with yourself, masturbation, and you know, this relationship and that relationship is off limits now, because if you do this, it will kill you. It will kill you emotionally, spiritually, and even physically. But I have a kind of sex that will not only benefit you, but it will benefit your family. It will benefit the generations after you. It will ultimately worship me, him. So now that I understand why he's saying no, not right now, or no, this is off limits, it's because he's protecting me. Because he has something bigger and better for me in the future. And for real, I've experienced those short moment satisfactions, those satisfactions that will get you on a high. It's so intoxicating. But when that high comes down and you crash to the bottom, oh, it's a pain and a crash like no other. And why go through that when you can wait? When you can wait and get the best thing that God has for you. So living for God is not a restriction life. It's an investment. It really is an investment. So when people say, or you may have that internal argument, why can't I? Why can't I? I need you to be able to start changing your perspective, because it's not a why can't I or I can't, but it's really a I don't even want to. I realize it's not even good for me. Why am I trying to fight to do something that's not even good for me? That is no benefit to my life at all. Because you may not be able to do this certain thing, but you can do so many other things that is so much better. So no, I don't want to do a lot of the things that is normal to the world. Because guess what? They're suffering the consequences of it all. I'm cool on that. I don't even want it no more. Because I want the real thing. I want the thing that's going to benefit my entire life. I don't want to be another Eve looking at something on the outside because it looks so good, being deceived only to crash in the end, only to be separated from God. I don't want that anymore. So God, guess what? your boundary lines, your restrictions that you have, I'm down for it. I'm down for it. Because those restrictions now is opening up my life for bigger and better in the future. I'm settled with that. I'm content with that. And I encourage you to be content with that too. Peace.